Joining us live from the New York Stock Exchange is Eric Dresselhaus, CEO. Thank you so much for joining us. Congratulations, big day for you and your company. Explain to our viewers what ESS Inc. does here.
Yeah, a big day and a lot of fun. So ESS is addressing, we think, one of the biggest challenges that we face in decarbonizing the energy system, which is how do we take renewable energy, wind, solar, that's made during the day, and store it so that we can use it overnight or when the wind isn't blowing or the sun isn't shining.
Eric, why was the right time now to go public for you?
Well, I think a couple of things. If you've followed what's happening in the news, I think the consciousness of the need to decarbonize the economy, decarbonize the energy system, is no longer in debate. So it's really now about getting to scale, building out the manufacturing capabilities, expanding the company globally, and this was a really efficient way for us to do that.
What sort of opportunities do you think this debut will unlock for your company moving forward?
Well, I think a number. I think from a go-to-market size, being on the exchange and having the resources to grow our business globally, to build out our team, is important. The other thing is we actually build the product. In Wilsonville, Oregon is where our manufacturing facility is, so we're expanding that now and expect to continue to expand that facility. So this is an American-made technology that's decarbonizing and greening the energy system, but that takes resources, and this funding helps us do that.
You mentioned this deal is backed by top investors, SB Energy Corp, of course, an arm of SoftBank and Fidelity. Eric, how did you manage to get these top dogs on board here?
Well, the top dogs are great to have on the team because they're really visionaries. The people that have joined this fight are people who, over the last number of years, really saw the need for energy duration, long-duration energy storage, to as this key missing link. So when they saw what we did, they saw that we could do it in a totally clean, non-toxic way that doesn't rely on rare earth minerals, using things mined in the Congo. I think they saw that potential as really too hard to pass up.
So you claim that your iron-based flow batteries are better than the alternative lithium-ion batteries, at least for long-duration grid energy storage. Can you explain to us why?
Sure. Well, lithium, everybody, your listeners are probably familiar with lithium. It's great. It's great for your phone. It's great for electric vehicles. But lithium's got some challenges. One of the challenges is it really doesn't work at very long durations. So the challenge that grid operators, large commercial customers are facing is, how do I create that 24/7 clean energy system? That's 8 to 12 hours where we don't have that sunshine and we don't have the wind blowing. So that's the first part of it. The second part is, people are increasingly worried about toxicity. Lithium has disposal issues. There are people working on that, but today we don't really have a great way to recycle those products. Our product's built with iron, salt, and water, so it's entirely non-toxic. It won't start fires. It won't blow up if it's in a fire. So areas like California, where there's wildfire risk, our battery is vastly superior to lithium or some of the other alternatives.
How is your company positioned to deal with these record high energy prices?
Yeah, well, it's I saw a really interesting analysis from Oppenheimer that just came out last week that said solar plus storage, long duration storage like we do, is now the absolute best economic value versus gas fire peaker plants. If you've noticed what's happened in the natural gas price world, prices are up to record highs. That's probably not going to come down anytime soon. So this isn't just cleaner and greener. It's actually a better economic story for consumers than the alternatives of fossil-based fuels.
Eric, what's next for the emerging long-duration energy storage market?
Well, I think we're seeing demand both from large grid operators, independent power producers, the people who build the big solar plant. They want to create that 24/7 system. But I think the other thing we're seeing a huge amount of demand, and this is really on a global basis, is it seems like we have a 100-year weather event about every week somewhere. And so resiliency, having the ability to have access to energy, is really important. And so we think that's going to be a big part of our growth driver, is how do we build a power system that's reliable so that when we flip the switch, the lights always come on.
I have less than a minute with you, Eric. SoftBank Energy also recently signed a $300 million deal for a record purchase of the company's batteries. Do we expect that kind of growth to continue?
We expect that the global market is really figuring out the need for long duration. When our renewables were 3, 4, 5% of the system, frankly, long duration wasn't as important. What's really changed now is systems are 25% or more decarbonized through renewable energy. And the goals in many geographies is to get to 100% renewable. And you can't do that without long duration. So I think this is really just the first of many steps we're going to see.
Well, congratulations on today. We hope you come back. We actually do a show called Cheddar Climate. I'd love to talk to you on that show as well. Eric Dresselhaus, CEO of ESS Inc. Thank you again for your time.